New Delhi as the parliament convenes on Friday for the winter session. The union cabinet is also meeting in the afternoon and is likely to clear the bill on triple talaq. TH bill piloted by the law ministry stems from the recent Supreme Court verdict banning instant divorce. The government intends to get the statute passed in the current session of parliament ending first week of January. Though several bills are slated to rule debates and be tabled this session, a few key ones stand apart for the heat they might generate. News 18 pieces together the top bill set to dominate this time. The Constitution 123rd Amendment Bill, 2017. Though this bill was not greeted warmly and led to an impasse in the last session of Parliament, the 123rd Amendment Bill, 2017, to grant constitutional status to the National Commission for Backward Classes NCBC will be again tabled this session in the Lok Sabha. The bill proposes to bring the 1993 established NCBC on a par with National Commission for Scheduled Castes NCSC and National Commission for Scheduled Tribes NCST. Though this bill was passed by the Lok Sabha, it met a roadblock in the Rajya Sabha when an amendment was brought in. The amendment expanded the three-member commission to five to give representation to a woman and a person from minority community and mandated that all five members should necessarily be from other backward classes OBC. The other amendment was in giving states a significant role in making recommendations to the list. This was done to strengthen the federal structure of our constitution. Law prohibiting triple talaq when the five-judge bench of the Supreme in a ratio of 32 declared that instant triple talaq was not an essential part of the Islamic law and faith, there were still cases on the rise of women having left helpless after the pronouncement of such instant divorces. The Muslim Women Protection of Rights on Marriage Bill, 2017. This law gives a woman the right to seek maintenance from her husband, in the case of instant triple talaq or talaq bidat, before a magistrate's court. The bill makes triple talaq a penal offense which has 3 years imprisonment for the guilty. Hence, lending an ear to the urgent call of a law prohibiting the practice on the lines of the SC verdict, the center plans to introduce a bill outlawing this Muslim practice this winter session. Bill to legalize the use of marijuana. If this private member bill legalizing the use of marijuana is passed, it would certainly be a game changer for the country, which asks us to treat drug addicts as patients and not criminals. The bill seeks to make amendments to the Narcotic Drugs and Psychotropic Substances NDPS Act of 1985, which was brought in order to meet conventions on drug policy laid out by the United Nations. The amendments laid out in the bill seek to enable medically supervised and state-regulated supply of traditionally used natural drugs for a common user. It will separate natural drugs from the artificial and synthetic ones. Currently, soft intoxicants, like bank cannabis, afim and bookie opium, are clubbed with artificial, hard, drugs such as smack, heroin, crack, and cocaine. Dharam Vera Gandhi, Member of Parliament from Patiala, Punjab, has been pushing for the legalization of marijuana or cannabis. Bill granting NRI the power to vote. Prime Minister Narendra Modi has time and again appealed to the Indian diaspora to be a part of India's development. But considering that a large number of Indians stay abroad, a bill granting them the power to vote would be tabled in this winter session. The bill would seek to amend the electoral law to allow non-resident Indians NRIs to vote through postal or ballots. The proposal was introduced when the centre made its submissions to ASC Bench of Chief Justice Deepak Misra and Justices A.M. Khanwilkar and D.Y. Chandrachud. The poll panel had said the move to allow NRIs to use proxy voting on the lines of defense personnel and a ballot facility would require changes either in the Representation of People Act or in the rules made under the Act. The center also submitted that the bill would take into account the recommendations made in a report prepared by a 12-member committee, led by the Deputy Election Commissioner Vinod Zuchi, to explore the feasibility of alternative options for voting by overseas electors. Bill to grant rights to transgenders. The Social Justice and Empowerment Ministry will be introducing the Transgender Persons Protection of Rights Bill, 2017. The bill was introduced in the Lok Sabha in August 2016 and was referred to the Standing Committee on Social Justice and Empowerment, chaired by BJP MP Ramesh Bais and 17 other Lok Sabha members, for examination on September 8, 2016. However, the ministry has been facing criticism for not having taken into account the recommendations made by the committee, which had suggested the definition of the term itself is against global norms and violates the right to self-determined gender identity. Apart from seeking justice for them, the bill also aims to provide transgenders with medical benefits as well as provide quotas in government colleges and jobs. Indian Forest Amendment Act. President Ramnath Kovind recently gave a nod to the Indian Forest Amendment Ordinance, 2017, amending the Indian Forest Act. Now, a bill replacing it will be tabled in this winter session. The ordinance has with immediate effect exempted bamboo grown in non-forest areas from the requirement of felling transit permit. The move is likely encourage bamboo plantation by farmers and help enhance their income and is done with a look east focus. Prior to this amendment, bamboo was treated as tree under the Indian Forest Act, 1927 and therefore, attracted the requirement of transit permit under the law even if it was grown on private land. Since getting such permit is quite a complicated process, it was identified as a major impediment for the cultivation of bamboo by farmers on non-forest land. The bill which is likely to be proposed has also the objective of benefiting the tribals as they and other forest dwellers. They have long asked for full rights to harvest and sell the fast-growing grass species that was denied to them by the colonial forest law. Education for Children, the Root Second Amendment Bill, 2017, introduced recently, revisits the no-detention policy. The Right of Children to Free and Compulsory Education Second Amendment Bill, 2017, proposes a regular examination, which will be held in Class 5 and Class 8 at the end of every academic year. If the student fails in the re-examination, the central or state governments may choose either not detain the child at all, or either detain the child in Class 5, Class 8, or in both classes. This is in contrast to the current policy where a child cannot be detained until the completion of Class 8. The bill has been passed by Lok Sabha. Citizenship for Minorities. The Citizenship Amendment Bill, 2016 proposes that illegal migrants from Afghanistan, Bangladesh and Pakistan from specified religious groups will be eligible to apply for Indian citizenship. The bill was introduced in the Lok Sabha in July 2016. The Citizenship Act of 1955 denies citizenship rights to any illegal immigrant, whereby an illegal immigrant is defined as a person who enters India without a valid passport or with forged documents, or who stays in the country beyond the visa permit. Proposed bill amends this definition to exclude minority religious individuals, especially Hindus, Sikhs, Jains, Parsis and Christians, from Muslim-dominated countries such as Afghanistan, Bangladesh and Pakistan from the ambit of being an illegal immigrant. The bill further reduces the requirement of 11 years to acquire citizenship by naturalization to only 6 years of ordinary residence for such immigrants.